r/AskReddit. What are some moments in movies that made you go up? It doesn't work like that. An explosion nearby and everyone talks and hears fine. I love that scene and the other guys about this. Goddammit tinnitus. You are a cruel mistress. Every time they perform CPR in a movie. Bonus points if the victim wakes up immediately and is totally fine and talking. There was a scene in the G.I. Joe Cobra movie where they torpedo icebergs, and then they sank. Yep, ice doesn't change its density to be heavier than water just because explosions. I have the perfect scientific explanation for this. That movie sucked. Frantically shouting taxi while hailing a cab. I heard a woman do that the other day and it shocked me because no one ever actually says that out loud like that. Pretty much any scene that involves biologists. Look, the DNA is a perfect match, as the computer superimposes two identical graphics that are basically just the symbol for DNA. DNA. And the fact that it takes them a few seconds to get the results. When a baby is born and it's a beautiful, squeaky clean 3-6-month-old twice the size of a newborn. They are tiny, goo-covered, swollen purple aliens IRL. Avalanches. Particularly when someone gets buried and then just bursts out of the snow unharmed. Avalanche debris sets like concrete. You're not getting out without help. And most deaths injuries occur from being bashed up during the slide. So you're not likely to emerge unscathed if it's big enough to bury you. As far as I know, trauma occurs from terrain traps, not necessarily the size. In NA most more deaths are from trauma whereas in Europe, where above treeline terrain is much more accessible, fatalities are typically deep burials. Also, sound triggering avalanches is a big one. Pretty much any scene where there's some magic computer program that turns blurry, heavily pixelated images into razor sharp photos? Yep, that doesn't exist. It's always a pet peeve of mine when in movies, they're working on a computer and the thing is constantly chirping and beeping with some kind of dumb sci-fi looking interface to it. Like dude, we all have computers now. We all know software doesn't do that and if it did it would be annoying as hell. I've even seen scenes, can't remember which movies, where they're clearly using Photoshop or something similar and it's constantly making little sci-fi noises. Or the classic Hackerman. 5 seconds of rapidly pressing random keys, typing something that's not even into any kind of input, pop-ups appearing faster than the human eye can follow, I'm in. The extent that people can get punched in the face and just keep going. No one is having Jason Bourne style fights and able to keep going for as long as they all do. Jack Bauer, dead for 4 minutes, jumping rooftop to rooftop 17 minutes later. Basically anytime they show lab work being done, they either don't wear PPE, or they do wear it but don't wear it properly, or for the right things. Food, beverage, chewing gum in a lab is a big no. If some character in a drama TV show walked into my lab demanding results, the first thing I'd do is give them safety glasses. Anytime someone is wearing rubber/latex nitrile gloves that are way too big, especially when dexterity is important, they could just flap their hand and it would fly off. It's useless. Drives me nuts. The protagonists and antagonists fighting on the streets and not giving a shit about thousands of people dying while the cars explodes and buildings falls. Our hero is beaten, stabbed and shot. Next scene he wakes up bandaged in the hospital. Within seconds, he yanks out all the tubes and wires, jumps out of bed, finds his suddenly clean clothes, and rushes out to continue his quest. In the next scene he's full of energy as he pursues his foe, and while his face may have a single scratch or bandaged cut, usually above one eye, there's no sign of what would ordinarily be a yellow-purple swollen pulpy mess with blood-red eyes. All the movies with science babble in them, or tech babble, all of them, at least it's pretty funny. Just stick dark energy or quantum physics somewhere. The quantum dark energy is spreading to his ass. Hacking is babbling about I'm in and you always have to trace the source I'm pretty sure. I'm in his Hante collection. Tracing the sources now. But what if we reverse the polarity? Then the Hante collection is in him. Almost any scene involving someone being shot or stabbed. As a cop, I've dealt with many stabbing victims. People don't just drop like sacks of potatoes when they are stabbed or have their throats slit. I once had to respond to an incident where two guys got into a knife fight, ended up having to help keep pressure on wounds as we waited for paramedics and he pulled through. His neck was wide open, and he had 23 punctures in his abdomen and arms. But he was still energetic and down to fight. When it comes to gunshots, you're not going to instantly drop unless something vital is hit. Heart. Brain. Act. Makes me laugh a little when watching movies and bad guys drop dead when they are shot or cut in any way by the good guys. 90% of the depictions of women going into labor. It's rarely mom feels fine all day, suddenly has one sharp contraction, water immediately breaks and makes a puddle on the floor. Everyone I know who's given birth has had at least a few hours contracting before the water breaking, if it breaks at all, and then it can be even longer before you're in active labor. Not a movie but in the show You, when he gives that guy the latte with nuts in it and he drops dead less than a minute later. Now, it takes a bit longer than that. It would be a much longer, painful demise. This is the same with people being shot in the abdomen. A bullet to the abdomen is usually the slowest way to die. It can kill you, but not in 2 minutes while you say goodbye to a loved one or finally give up that crucial bit of info you've been hiding all along. One that always gets me is when medical professionals shock a flatline heart rhythm. It doesn't seem to matter what caused them to flatline either. It's straight to the defib. Like guys, it's designed to stop the heart, with the hopes it will restart with a normal rhythm. It doesn't start a stopped heart. They with use drugs like adrenaline, I assume, not a doctor, and use CPR for any other reason. There is no cleaning up before or after sex. Everyone is just ready to go all the time. People in movies being scientists, meaning they are good at all forms of science, biology, electrical engineering, physics, programming, communication protocols, advanced mathematics, hacking, robotics. Sure, you could have some knowledge in all of those fields, but specializing in just one of them takes decades. These characters are usually wizards in all fields. In Interstellar, when they have combines running through a field of green corn, they spent a ton of time getting little details of astrophysics right, then fell flat on their face in the depiction of farming. And the best part is, I read somewhere that they actually did grow and harvest that corn to pay for some costs of the movie, so it's not like they didn't know how harvesting actually works. When hackers just spam random letters to hack. Just about every movie where anything does anything in space, I can count the exceptions on one hand. Ships burning prograde into re-entry, maneuvering hilariously close, and 99% of the time burning in the wrong direction. Imagine an action movie where everyone runs into the big fight shooting themselves in the head as if that would kill their enemy. It's painful. Telling co-workers to cover your shift on the fly, like okay, like I don't have to run it by the manager and the manager doesn't have to do a whole bunch of computer shit beforehand to fix the hours up. I've worked in the service industry most of my career and this has always bothered me. That, and the bookstore clerk living in a $1 million loft in the city. I refuse to see the movie Lucy because it was based around the myth we only ever use 10% of our brain. Like, no we don't, we use the whole thing. We cannot just unlock our brains with fancy tech or drugs and suddenly have telekinesis and shit. The movie 2012. Just like, all of it. Most explosions. I was in ammo and it ruined most movies for me. They're still fantastic movies and I love them all. But when a building explodes, you're not gonna walk out casually barely beating the flames. And those thousands of pieces of wood aren't all going to magically not impale you as they're hurtled all around you with incredible force. That thing where a tech lab procedure suddenly takes half the time because someone offers to pay more. No. If it needs to be centrifuged for 24 hours, it's still going to take 24 hours even with 100k on the table. Also not as jarring. But everyone always wakes up with perfect makeup and no one ever seems to clean their face. There's the trope of people in advertising having to stay late around the holidays, rushing to finish up the holiday campaign for the new client and having to choose between their career and their family. Yeah, that would not happen very often. In reality, the holiday campaign would have been finalized quite some time ago after months of planning, back and forth with the client, reviewing layouts, proofs, etc. Around the holiday season, we would most likely be working on planning stuff for the spring-summer of the next year. Sorry if someone has already commented this. I didn't want to scroll through all of them. Chloroform. It takes several minutes to knock you out, and you won't be out for that long. I promise I know this because we use chloroform to clean stuff in the lab I intern at, and my advisor told me this, in case the FBI is reading this. Rolling out of a speeding car. Nah man, you're about to look like you made out with a cheese grater. Every movie scene where anyone is using a chainsaw, they don't start from cold with just one pull, they need a little while to warm up. And you sure as shit can't cut through flesh and bone without ducking that chain up real good. Looking at you, Evil Dead. Movies set a long time ago trying to emulate people from 500-2000 years ago, but they all have perfect skin and white teeth. In the disaster movies, people don't hoard toilet paper. Scenes that involve swimming. I try to hold my breath whenever a movie character, non-superhero fantasy, dives underwater and try to hold it as long as he or she is swimming or submerged. I end up dying 9 out of 10 times. I mean, there's probably a lot of things to consider, but the amount of time some characters can hold their breaths is superhuman. The big ass computer room in the basement of the airplane where 6 special ops soldiers can hide. They would sell seats down there if there was that much room. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.